Hello everyone. Today we want to talk about a common problem that children face when they are solving problems of algebra in the topic of one variable linear equations. First of all, let's understand what is a one variable linear equation. This is called a one variable linear equation because there is only one variable called the x. We don't have x, y, z, many different things. We have only one variable. That's why it's called a single variable. Why is it a linear equation? Because the variable is raised to the power of 1. When you do not have any power, that means it is raised to the power of 1. Because it is raised to the power of 1, we call it as a linear equation. Now, if you see here, I have written two different equations. And children usually get confused about which operation they have to transpose. First, let us understand what is transpose. Let me give you a simple example. Now, if we have a simple equation with, say, 3s is minus 4 is equal to 10, something like this. Okay. To make it much simpler, let's just take s minus 4 is equal to 10. Okay. What do we mean by transposition of things? Is we take this minus 4 to the right hand side of the equation, and thereby this minus 4 becomes a plus 4. That is one way of understanding. So we have s is equal to 10 plus 4. Giving you a 14. Some children understand or learn this way. Some other children learn it in the form of balancing the equation. Both the ways is the same thing, talking about two different ways. Now, if we have to balance something, balance the equation, what do we do? Because we don't want a minus 4 this side, we add a plus 4. This left side of the equation as well as the right side of the equation, so that both the sides are equal again. So we get a s plus 0 is equal to 14. So finally we get a s is equal to 14. Sometimes they do this way, or just s minus 4 is equal to 10. They bring it to the right side. They transpose it. What is it? The transpose means minus 4 becomes a plus 4. This is called transposition. Minus 4 becomes negative, becomes positive, positive becomes negative. Something that is multiplied becomes divided. Something when it travels across the equation sign. The way I tell students about this whole transposition is, I ask them to imagine the equal to sign as if it's a bridge. And the minus 4 is crossing the bridge of equal to sign. When it is crossing the bridge, it changes its sign or changes its operation. Minus becomes a plus. So, we've understood what is transposition. Yet, even after knowing what is transposition, children get confused about when many different operations are there. How do we start the transposition? Which number should we deal with? Here, for example, children start thinking about, okay, let me do this 5, which is here. So, because it is divided here, let me multiply 5. They go ahead and multiply 5 on the right-hand side. They get a 9 times 5. But that's not right. Okay. Let's solve this doubt. Let's solve this thing once for all. Let's imagine the X to be a man. X to be a man. The variable to be a man. The man first wears a vest or a banyan. On top of that, he wears a shirt. On top of that, he wears a coat. So, when he is removing his clothes, how will he remove? First, he will remove his outermost covering of clothing, that is the coat. Then he'll remove the shirt. Then he'll remove his banyan or the vest. So what is very closest to his body, he will remove at the last, right? Now, think this X as a man. What is the outermost covering, outermost thing? Or let's start from which is the innermost thing, which is very near to him. It is the tree. It is a tree which is very near to him, very near to the variable X. And next near thing is this 5, is this 5. Next thing that is there is this 5. So when we are removing the operations from the X, we must remove from the outermost thing, that is the coat. Now I will call this as the coat, this as the shirt, and this 3 as the vest. So first the man will remove the coat. So what happens when we transpose that positive 5, we get a negative 5 on the right side of the equation, which we get as 4, right? Now we are left with the vest and the shirt. What is the next thing that he will remove? It is a shirt that he will remove. That means 3x and the 5, which was the shirt, it is divided. When we transpose it, it becomes multiplied. So we get 3x is equal to 20. Now, when we want to do the next thing, we have to remove the vest, the 3. Now many children get confused. What is the meaning of 3x? Anything beside a variable is actually multiplied. So there's a multiplication here, which is not specifically written. So 3 is multiplied. So when we transpose, we actually divide the 3 when it crosses the bridge of equal to sign. So this is the value of X. And this is how we solve using transposition. Let's see in this second problem, what's the difference? Okay, now, which is very near to the variable X? It is the 3. It is the 3. Now, this 3 becomes the vest. Which is the next thing which is nearby? No, it is not the division sign, because it is farther away, because it is including even the 5, this 5 as well. So the next thing, the shirt, is this 5. This is the shirt. And much farther than that is the bottom 5, which is the coat. As we know, first we have to remove the outermost thing, that is the coat. So 5, this bottom 5 is divided, we know that. So when we transpose it and bring it to the right hand side, it gets multiplied. So we get 3x plus 5 is equal to 50. Now, the next thing that we are to remove is the shirt, and the shirt is the other 5. And that is added. Because it is added, when we do the transposition, it becomes subtraction. So 3x is equal to 50 minus 5. So 3x is equal to 45. Now, as I already explained, 3x means it is a 3 multiplied with x, and we know we have to remove the last and final thing, that is the vest, the banyan. And so because it is multiplied, we are going to divide it and make it 45 divided by 3. That is giving you 15, and that is our value for x. I hope this simple trick helps you solve one variable linear equations very nicely, very easily. Thank you.